A firebrand is a smoldering ember that's flying through the air. Firebrands are dangerous because they can loft for long distances and start a secondary fire. Firebrands have been known to jump interstate highways, rivers, and fire breaks and start secondary fires that way. It's not normally measured in meters, but measured in kilometers.
The problem is when these firebrands start to accumulate in groups under the right conditions where they're exposed to an increased airflow of oxygen driven into this firebrand pile. This firebrand pile starts to get hot. The board or the decking material starts to heat up, thermally decompose, and could potentially ignite.
There was a study done on the 2007 Witch Creek fire, and it was found that about 2/3 of every structure destroyed was due to firebrand exposure. We take these little dowels and we expose them to a propane burner, we burn them, we get them to a glowing state. We dump the firebrands in, and then we close off the wind tunnel, and then we both video record, we also are taking gas analyzing data, and then we're also looking at temperature readings from these firebrands.
What we're trying to figure out is to actually develop different pyrolysis models for different materials, how it will decompose when heat is exposed to the board, which could potentially be used in the future for accurate simulations of fire spread, which could help the fire service in accurately predicting how fires would spread in the community and potentially saving structures before they are actually exposed to these firebrands.
If you look at the damage from wildland fires in the urban interface, you'll see 10 houses destroyed and one that's preserved. And what's different about that house is that often they're protected against the firebrands. The roof material, the gutters, can ignite from the firebrands. Cleaning off the debris on your deck can make a big difference in having a fire break around your house. All these things can help.